ever since Overwatch was first released, I've not stopped playing it. I think I might be a little obsessed. In fact, I love it. But the problem is, I'm pretty sure the game doesn't love me back.
Yeah, we could do this with two mains and a Hanzo and no healer. It's fine. What did I... Why won't you die? No! Yes, of course, totally.
Not only is it pretty apparent that the game doesn't like me, I think I have a problem when it comes to communicating with Anna.
Don't worry, my friends.
What? I'm... No! Oh, no!
Needless to say, I'm not the biggest fan of Blizzard's most recently released hero. However, over the last few months, Blizzard has been teasing us with rumours of a new hero, the hero we have all been waiting for, and an alternate reality game countdown indicating that we will be seeing the one and only Sombra at this Halloween event. Furthermore, the hype train was well and truly fueled when Blizzard released, or somebody at Blizzard released, an image of Sombra herself. Though it isn't guaranteed that Sombra is going to be a playable character, regardless, in combination with the artwork and the logo, this is pretty inspirational stuff. For this nail art, I used OPI nail laquer. I can't actually remember the name of this particular white, but I found it to be the thickest and most opaque, perfect for using on a base. Prior to doing any complex nail art like the one I'm about to show you, I ensured that I applied a thick base coat. Any base coat will do. I'm pretty sure mine cost me about 99p from the local superdrug. Yes, I know. I'm committing a crime by not telling you about the awesomeness of some miracle base coat that's out there. For this design, I decided to use the Sombra logo as my accent nail. Using a striping brush and a very thin amount of random purple nail polish I had lying around, I sketched out the outline of the Sombra logo on my thumbnail. In hindsight, using a striping brush probably wasn't the best idea for this, but it was the only way I could get reasonably straight lines. Once you've completed your outline, fill in the background with whatever random purple nail polish you have lying around. If you're anything like me though, you might want to go back and sharpen those lines with a little bit of that extra white nail polish. Using a striping brush, create four lines at the base of the skull to make teeth. Using a smaller rounded brush, I used black nail polish to dot the eyes. Initially, I found that the black paint was rather stiff. I realised applying a small amount of nail varnish remover to the black polish made it easier to work with. Once the eye holes are dry, apply six dots around the edges. I know it's meant to be six triangles, but unfortunately, I don't have microvision, therefore I can't actually see that fine detail. Once your eye holes and your six dots around each eye are dry, feel free to apply a tiny amount in the center of the skull for the nose. For the next step, I wanted to make a purple gradient similar to the design seen on Sombra's artwork. As with any gradient, you simply need to apply a thin amount of each colour in lines across a sponge. Try not to apply too much because this will smudge when you apply it to your nail. Dab, 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 dab. I repeated the process twice. This allowed me to get the consistency needed for the next step. I'll be doing some stamping using Holy Shapes from MoYou London, collection number 5 XL. For the base stamp, I'll be using MoYou London's Sweet Westiria, and for the second stamp, I'll be using MoYou London's Surf Sop. I only use a small amount of nail polish along the edge of the stamp. As I explained in my last video, this helps to save money and polish over time. Simply stamp it onto your nail and repeat the process 3 more times. Using MoYou London's Surf Sop for the second stamp, I repeated the process with 2 simple lines, placing across the centre of the previous. Once the stamp is completely dry, usually about 5 to 10 minutes, apply a thick glossy top coat. I'll leave the details in the description below, along with all of the other polishes I've used today, including the stamping plate and nail stamper. And here you go, a Sombra-inspired nail art. Hopefully me and Sombra will have a better relationship than Anna. Tell me what you think of this design in the comments below, and feel free to like and subscribe for future designs. Until next time, I'll see you in the battlefield fighting Dr. Junkenstein Zomnix.